piece you just heard was Movie Milestones by Hans Zimmer. It featured familiar medleys from Driving Miss Daisy, Gladiator, Madagascar, Crimson Tide, The Lion King, and The Pirates of the Caribbean. I'm sure you recognize some of them. The next piece we will be playing is Sterling Brass, composed by James Barnes. His numerous publications for concert band and orchestra are extensively performed in the United States, Europe, and the Pacific Rim. At one time in our musical history, even concert bands relied heavily on the audience-pleasing marches. Barnes gives us a highly traditional march packed with all the ingredients that bring cheers from listeners the world over.
Saxophones. And it's so remarkable that he can adjust his embouchure, that's the way he holds the muscles of his face, so that he can go from the largest and softest mouthpiece, the bass saxophone, to the smallest and tightest and most difficult of all the reed instruments, the oboe. And dancing to this captivating melody will be the Allegro dancers, featuring dancers at Thea Froelert and Katie Frostlethwaite in a dance choreographed by Jade Chavetsky.
Oh, When the Sidney Concert Band toured Eastern Cuba in 2017, we heard street vendors in several cities advertising their wares, including calls of "Manis, Manis," which means peanuts, peanuts, and provides the title of the last piece of Manacero, or the Peanut Seller, probably the most famous Cuban song ever written, and one reason the room became so popular in the 30s. The next selection is actually several selections. When I introduced this group exactly a year ago, I talked mostly about the odd little street in Victoria, said they were named for it, but they claim it was named for them. This time around, I'd like to talk about their music. They started out as a barbershop quartet with the Victoria Barbershop Harmony Society, but decided to branch out from the barbershop repertoire, which has lots of songs, but it's quite limited as a genre. So they sing a number of songs that are not traditional barbershop, but they maintain the barbershop harmony. And if you ever wondered why barbershop quartets sound the way they do, pay attention. All notes have several sounds, the lowest pitch on a fundamental tone, and several overtones, which ordinarily you can't hear because they're drowned out by the fundamental. But in barbershop singing, the notes of certain chords are chosen because they have the same overtone, which is made louder because it builds on all four voices. So you hear not only the four notes that are being sung, but also a fifth note, the overtone common to each note, which changes the chord to a five-note chord, which is called a ringing chord. And so when you hear a chord that sounds different during the performance, that's a ringing chord. And finally, there's something called a harmonic seventh chord, which is way more complicated than I will try to explain, but I suggest you look it up because it will be on the final exam. Please welcome back the Trout Sally Quartet.
Na 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 na. 1965, the Beatles won 7 gold records that year, 1965, and 8 Days a Week was one of those records. It was thought that maybe it would be a really good idea to include a song like that in the movie Help. But somebody disagreed with that, and if you look at the movie Help and what songs it was in, that was in that song, 8 Days a Week wasn't in it. Well, pretty sad. However, there is a DVD of the story of the Beatles on tour. Did you know they never sang that song in the live performance? That's what Google told me.
We just didn't.
They did as well. It must be true. Anyway, we have another song to sing now. Our second to last song is All of Me. All of Me was written as a classic almost 100 years ago. In 1932, it appeared in the movie Careless Lady. How many of you have seen that movie? At any rate, All of Me goes on to be recorded by many, many other folks, including Frank Sinatra and that other guy these guys were talking about earlier.
Rock guy.
Yeah. Willie Nelson.
Willie Nelson did this.
And it also went on to win a major award, the best song ever sort of thing, by the Songwriters Association of North America. Anyway, we're going to sing All of Me, but it's got a little bit different. You know, you talked about earlier in the introduction about four-part harmony. Good luck, Paul.
Not worries. My favorite version, just to say, Steve Martin and Lily Tomlin back in the kind of in the mid-80s, they sang this, while the song was sang in that movie, and the movie was of the same name. It was All of Me. Yeah. Cool. Very tricky. You took my kisses and you took my love. You taught me how to care. Am I to be just a remnant of a one-sided love affair? All you took, I gladly gave. There's nothing left for me to say.
1, 2, 3, 4.
All of me. Why not take all of me? Can't you see I'm no good without you? Take my lips, I want to lose them.
What's the name of the song?
You got a friend in me. And it kind of harkens to the fact that, you know, we've been singing together as a quartet for the last 13 years or so. We've become very close friends because of that. And we've done now a couple of shows with these guys, and we're making friends here. So I think the song kind of harkens to how important friendship is in a life. And you can't really get by without it. So anyway, without further ado. Son, you've got a friend in me.
I'm saying you've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me.
You've got trouble. I can choose. There isn't anything I
wouldn't do for you. We stick together, we can see it through, cause you've got a friend.
Audrey Hepburn to sing in the 1961 movie Breakfast at Tiffany's. A Paramount Picture executive had suggested removing the song after a rather tepid LA preview, but Hepburn used her most colorful language to tell them that it would be over her dead body if they tried to cut it. The song won an Academy Award for Best Original Song in that movie and a Grammy for Song of the Year. Moon River went on with wings of its own to become a favorite of many artists over the years, including Andy Williams, who sang the first eight bars at the beginning of each episode of his TV shows and also titled his autobiography, Moon River. The song's success also relaunched Mercer's flagging career as a songwriter. This beautiful arrangement by Michael Brown provides a rich tapestry for the concert band accompaniment, and especially for the horns. Today you have the pleasure of hearing Nicola's version of this classic, recognizable, and well-loved song.
Moon
applause. That was amazing.
Over the years, we've had some really great singers, and Nicola is one of them, so pretty awesome. So it comes to the point in time in the concert that I'd like to thank some people for making this concert what it is. So I'd like to thank Ken Falks, who is instrumental in making our posters and helps with our website, the Artsea Foundation, who have helped us financially throughout the years, the Charlie White Theater staff, Sienna Shepherd on lights, up in the booth up there. Jesse Bannerman on sound, who's up in the booth. Paul Masters, who's the stage manager. And Joe Barker, who's the theater manager. Without the staff here at the Charlie White Theater, this wouldn't take place. What you see on stage wouldn't happen. With the lighting and the sound and everything, it's just amazing. They just do a wonderful job. So thank you to them. And to make this not a concert, but a show, we bring in guest performers. So the Sidney Brass, again, who were out in the lobby when you walked in for the show today, just amazing. So I'd like to thank the Sidney Brass. And again, Trounce Alley, Alan, Dave, Paul, and Bob, amazing. The Allegro dancers, Edza, Abigail, Charlotte, Katie, and Sean, and their choreographers, Jennifer and Jade. Another great show, and we love having you all with us. A big round of applause to Sue and Norm. And in the background, you don't get to see him, but he's the one that's been running the slideshow, Screamin' John, who's in the back there. The gentleman that kept us all in order and got us onto the stage in one piece without any difficulties, that would be Don Hauser, our stage manager. And I'd like to thank the MCs for today's performance. Hillary in the horn section. Not to be outdone. We have Jim in the saxophone section. We have Ian on flute. Myself, percussion and saxophone. And the concert band can't do this without your wonderful support. You support us for our main concerts, or two concerts per year, and we want to thank you for coming out and supporting us, because we enjoy practicing, but to do this to a live audience is something else. So thank you from all of us. And talking about concerts, so every year the Sidney Concert Band does two main performances, our Salute to Veterans concert in November, tickets are on sale for that, by the way, and our spring concert at the end of May, which we're at right now, plus we do some smaller engagements throughout the year. If we didn't have such a talented, organized, and OCD director, this would never happen. I would like to say a huge thank you to the man that keeps all of us on track and time, and yet, none of us watch him, Maestro Bruce Hamm. Your countless hours and emails, oh, did I say emails? Make this concert a show. And your dedication to us make all of us better musicians. So thank you, Bruce. And before I introduce the next song, there happens to be somebody in the band that's celebrating a birthday today. Now, I'm not going to say what her age is, because, you know, that would be very impolite. But Yvonne, where are you, Yvonne? Yes, I know. Yes. Yvonne in her clarinet section, it's her birthday today. So with the band's help, I think maybe we can sing her happy birthday. So we'll get Bruce to start it off here.
Dear, so very much for coming out this afternoon. It was a beautiful day out there, and I've been hearing your book. So thank you. We really appreciate your patronage over the years, and we hope to see you again very soon.